Za mňou na slajde je otázka, respektíve sada otázok, ale všetky sa týkajú Čabu Krasnaja. Verím, že otázky si prečítal, ja len veľmi stručne zhrniem. Týka sa v podstate spolupráce univerzity, v rámci ktorej Čaba pôsobí so súkromným sektorom a takisto s verejným sektorom. Nech sa páči.
First of all, thank you very much for the questions. I think those are the most relevant questions. As the first question is regarding the connection with the foreign universities. Answer: in our case, as we are the governmental university, it is usually not as easy as it seems to be. So this is also true, like in every other parts of cybersecurity. First, build the trust, and second, maintain the trust. So, of course, we have foreign connections. First of all, we have traditional historical connections from the 70s and the 80s with the different military academies, like the Military Academy in Warsaw, Military Academy here in Liptovský Mikuláš, and the lost connection in Brno, unfortunately. Those are works, as we have decades-long trust with the universities. We also have some new connections that should be built up the trust, for example, with the Tallinn Technical University, which is very close to the NATO Cyber Defense Center. We started the discussion 2 years ago, and now we reached the agreement that we will need an Erasmus program, and in the future we are aiming a common joint master program. So therefore we should put the efforts into the trust building. The same will happen, and those are very surprising situation, as it turned out that at the Tallinn University there's a Hungarian lady who is living there for 15 years, and she started the discussion with us, and that helps a lot. Or rather, another example, in Spain, the University of León, we have an Erasmus agreement with them, but it turned out that the University of León is one of the key cybersecurity excellence centers of the Spanish government. Therefore, I will travel there in this year and start this trust building. So you should build it up. And there are countries and there are universities that will never reach that level of trust to work together. I think you know that which country I think about. The next question is about the education, how we are going after the market needs to set up the education needs. First of all, for us the market is the government, and the steering committee that I've mentioned is the feedback committee that help us to understand their needs. So 2 years ago we started with a discussion that, oh, we need hackers. Okay, why do you need hackers? What kind of hackers do you need? On what level? And we reached the agreement that now we have the master program that clearly reflects to the governmental needs and clearly reflects to the numbers that the Hungarian government needs and is able to build in to their system. Moreover, we are also talking with the private sectors, as we clearly see that not all of our students will go to the governments, but many of them will go to the private sector. Therefore, just an example, in the last month we had the European Cybersecurity Month. And in all weeks in October we had an event for our students. And we invited the representatives of the private sector, so we even have a large roundtable where large multinational companies, small local companies, or even security operation centers of large companies like the City Group or which was the other one? T-Systems were there, and they told that what is their needs, and of course, besides these sessions, we are talking with those colleagues, and they help us to understand what is their needs, and we are trying to build in their needs into our systems. And the last question is about the triangle. I wouldn't say this is just a try, because there are four parties: private, public, academia, and civilians. As in Hungary, we have a very good community of cybersecurity experts on different sectors. The communities are working well since the beginning of the 90s, so we are also talking with them. First of all, we have a formal way, which is written in the law. This is the Cybersecurity Coordination Forum. And this Cybersecurity Coordination Forum is led by the Cybersecurity Coordinator of Hungary, and he's responsible for the official way. On the other hand, on the non-official way, of course, I think that this 10 million people, the country with 10 million people is small enough to know about each other, and everything happens in Budapest, therefore we simply know each other. And we are talking with each other. Of course, that needs the trust we have for the gate, let's say. And therefore, we almost know everything. So just reflect to my colleague sitting there with the headphones. He is also one of a key member of the Hungarian cybersecurity community. So therefore, we spent 2 hours together next to a coffee up there, and we talked the actual information what we have from the local cyberspace. So trust, build the trust, maintain the trust, not just inside the government, but outside the government, between the different entities, and how the government supports this. We need to inform them, and we are informing them on what happens. And through the steering committee, we are usually getting the approval to, yes, do this. This is good.
There's one more question for you.
Okay. Are you a member of ECTEG? No, unfortunately not. We are the member of the ESDC, the European Security and Defense College, which is operating under EDA, the European Defense Agency. And yesterday and on Monday and of course today, we have the first official training under ESDC in its cyber platform.
Could you please explain the abbreviation?
Yeah, sure. So ESDC is responsible for the military Erasmus program in Europe, and they are responsible to coordinate the defense-related educations inside Europe and inside NATO. And my university is the only Hungarian member. And the ESDC started its cyber platform, cyber security-related education platform, at the end of September. That was initiated there, and its aim is to provide high level strategic and of course tactical operational level education for everyone who is working in the defense sector. I mean, wears a uniform or should have a rank or something, and we universities can provide trainings for all of the European officers. And we started that on this week, so we are member there. But of course, we are seeking for other memberships, and we are also trying to share the information what we have. And hopefully, after this discussion, I will also share my experiences regarding the exercises, because I found some interesting topics there. And what is happening is in Brno is great, and I continuously trying to read the publications of this coming from the Brno University. So yes, I think in cybersecurity, the cooperation is the key. Information sharing is the key. In our role, on our chair, many times it's difficult. But at the end, it turns out that if you are waiting in the difficulties and the opportunities are always much, much better.
Well, I hope that this workshop will help to restore the cooperation with the University in Brno, which has been seized, as you mentioned. Okay. Dámy a páni, má niekto z vás ešte otázku, komentár? Takisto naši diskutéri, ak chcú spraviť nejaké vyhlásenie záverečné alebo podeliť sa ešte s nejakým postrehom, názorom. Nie, takže ešte sa pozriem za mňa na slajdu. Môžem? Je to čisté. Takže všetko sme zodpovedali. Ja vám veľmi pekne ďakujem všetkým, aj tí, čo ste boli v hľadisku, aj tí, čo ste boli na tejto strane. Ďakujem, že ste prišli a ja dúfam, že sa ešte niekedy uvidíme. ITAPA tu bude aj budúci rok, takže nech sa páči. Budeme radi, keď ešte prídete. Ďakujeme.